So good morning everyone. So last lecture we will start the we started the enterprise resource planning, that is the ERP. So ERP is stand for the enterprise resource planning. So you know. So उसमें से हमने कुछ points देखे थे, like introduction देखा था, then concepts of enterprise resource planning देखा था, then functional units of ERP देखे थे, there are some functional module देखे थे हमने, and now today we learn the ERP and related technology, ERP solutions providers, that is the जो भी solutions रहते हैं वो देखने वाले, उसके packages रहते, then ERP and internet, then advantages of ERP और benefits of ERP. एंड जहाँ बेनिफिट्स होते हैं वहाँ लिमिटेशंस भी होते हैं, तो वो भी देखने वाले. एंड देर आर दिस सम फ्यूचर ऑफ ईआरपी. सो ये सारे पॉइंट्स हम कंटिन्यू करने वाले हैं नाउ टुडे. सो नाउ टुडे विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम ईआरपी एंड रिलेटेड टेक्नोलॉजी. ओके सो वन सेकेंड. ERP and related technology. So हमें पता है what is ERP and उसके जो related technology हम अभी देखने वाले. So ERP is the technique and concepts for the integrated management of the business as a whole from the viewpoint of the effective use of management resources to improve the efficiency of an enterprise. Okay. So ERP systems serve and important functions by integrating separate businesses, functions, materials, management, so product planning, sales, distribution, finance and accounting, so other into a single application. Okay, so there are the main technology that helps to overcome these limitations. So these technologies when use a conjunction with the ERP packages, okay, so help in overcoming the limitations of standalone ERP system. So thus help the employees to make better decision some of these technologies. Okay, so these technologies are like first one is the product lifecycle management. Okay, so that is the PLM. PLM stand for the product lifecycle management. So now we will start the product lifecycle management. So PLM is an important management system, so that integrates the data, process, business system and people in extended enterprise. Okay, so it refers to the handling of goods as it moves through the typical stages of this product life. So like development and introduction, growth, maturity or stability and decline. So this handling involves both the manufacturing of the good and the marketing of it. So this is the product life cycle management. So the concepts, okay, the concepts of life cycle helps inform the business decision making, okay, from the pricing and promotion to the expansion or cost cutting. Okay, so product lifecycle management has the many benefits, such as getting the product to market, okay, product to market faster, putting a higher quality product on the market, so improving the product safety, then increasing sales opportunities and reducing the you can say the reducing the errors and waste. So specialize the computer software is available to assist with PLM, okay, with PLM through function such as the document management, okay, then design integration and process management. So this is all are the product lifecycle management. So it is a PLM. So PLM stand for the product lifecycle management. It is the first technology of ERP. Now, second, management information system. Okay, that is the MIS, management information system. MIS. So okay, MIS stand for the management information system. So the goals of MIS are to implement of the organizational structure and the dynamic of the enterprise. Okay, so enterprise for the purpose of managing the organization in better we can say better way and capturing the potential of the information system for the competitive advantages. So the three components of the MIS provides more complete and focused definition. So where the system suggests the integration, okay, and holistic view. So information stands for process, data, and management is the ultimate user, the decision maker. So an enterprise mainly contains different categories of employees, like clerk, assistant officer, okay, you can say the executives, managers, and so on. So all of them are the user of MIS. Okay, yes, जो सारे लोग रहते वो MIS के user रहते. So MIS will collect the relevant data from the inside and outside of the enterprise. So this data is processed and stored in centralized database. हमने देखा है sir, what is the centralized database in previous lecture. So and is made available to its user whenever it is needed. So MIS has the capability to generate the report as and when the user demand it. So this is the all are the MI related to the MIS. So MIS stand for the Management Information System. Okay, that's to implement and organize the structural and dynamic of the enterprise for the purpose of managing the organization. Okay, so now next, supply chain management, which is very simple. Okay, SCM. Okay, SCM stand for the supply chain management. So supply chain management is the management of the flow of goods. Okay, flow of goods and services, and includes all the processes that transform raw material into final product. It is right, all process and transaction raw material into final product. So it involves the active streamlining of a business supply side activities to maximize the customer value and gain the competitive advantage in the marketplace. So SCM, that is SCM stand for the supply chain management, begins with collecting raw material. Okay, begins collecting with raw material and ends with receiving the goods by the consumer. Okay, so it is very important for the companies to more product to their customers quickly. Faster product delivery or availability will increase the sales and satisfaction of the customer. So it is very important to manage the activities in supply chain management, or software packages are available in the market for managing the same. So this is the supply chain management, we can say the SCM. So SCM stand for the supply chain management. Okay, now next technology is customer relationship management, that is the CRM. Okay, customer relationship management, customer relationship management, that is the CRM. So CRM is the term of applied to a process implemented by company, and it is the combination of practices, strategies, and technology that computer user manage and analyze the customer interaction. So data throughout the customer life cycle. So here it is the life cycle. So the goal is improve the customer service relationship and assist in the customer retention and drive the sales growth. So customer relation management, that is the CRM, is the combination of practices, strategies, and technology that companies use to manage and analyze the customer interactions and data through the customer life cycle. So the goal is improve the customer service relationship and assist in customer retention and drive the sales growth. So customer want the assurance that their data is not shared with the third parties without their consent. So CRM system compile customer data across the different channel. So CRM system can also the giving customer facing staff member detailed information on customer, then personal information, purchase history, buying preference, and concern. So it is a process of CRM. First one is the marketing, then sales, then feedback, and then support to the product. So it is a customer relationship management. So if this technology requirement of customer relationship management, that is the CRM, consists of database to store the entire information about the customer. So like interacting, analyzing, and supporting to the customer. Now फिफ्थ टेक्नोलॉजी डिसीजन सपोर्ट सिस्टम. ओके, डिसीजन सपोर्ट सिस्टम दैट इज द DSS. सो डिसीजन सपोर्ट सिस्टम आर इंटरैक्टिव कंप्यूटर बेस्ड सिस्टम एंड दैट एड यूजर इन जजमेंट एंड चॉइस द एक्टिविटीज. ओके, इट इज अ कंप्यूटर प्रोग्राम एप्लीकेशन दैट एनालिसिस द बिजनेस डेटा एंड प्रेजेंट्स इट सो दैट द यूजर कैन मेक बिजनेस डिसीजन मोर इजिली. So DSS, emphasis, that is the DSS stand for the decision support system. A knowledge management, we can say the perspective, it focuses on providing help in analyzing the situation. So rather than the providing right information in the form of various types of reports. So DSS needs a strong database management system to provide the support in decision making. Okay, so decision support system. So it is there are the some characters DSS is designed to address semi-structured, okay, and unstructured problem. So the DSS main supports the decision making at the top of the management level. And we can third characteristic like DSS is interactive, user friendly. Can be used by the decision maker with the little or no assistance from a computer professional. So this is all are the ERP related technology. Okay, so kaun se humne dekhe ERP technologies. First one is the PLM, that is the product life cycle management. Second one is the management information system, that is the MIS. Third one is the supply chain management, that is the SCM. And fourth one is the customer relationship management, that is the CRM. And fifth one is the decision support system, that is the DSS. Now next point is ERP solution provides. So jo bhi solution rehte wo kaun se hame dekhne uske packages jo rehte wo diye unhone. So selection of ERP packages is very crucial in the implementation of an ERP system. So there are the so many vendors, okay, ERP vendors in the world. So some of the popular ERP accounting packages are being explained here. First one is the Oracle. Okay, so Oracle is originally supplied a relational database that integrated with ERP software developed by SAP before entering the broader enterprise market in big way in the early 2000s. So the ERP 310 packages, ERP 31 packages from the Oracle provide strong finance and accounting module. So it also provides good customer and supplier interactions, effective production, analyze the efficient human resources, and management and better pricing module. So this is the Oracle solution provider. So it is a we can see the accounting packages, ERP accounting packages. Now second one is the SAP. Okay, SAP is the powerful ERP. SAP stand for the system application and protocol. First one is the SAP stand for the system application and product. So powerful ERP software SAP is designed by a prominent software provider. So SAP ERP stand for system application and product for data processing. So SAP developed the customer relationship management, that is the CRM, and supply chain management, that is the SCM, and product lifecycle management, that is the PLM software. Now next one is the Odoo. Okay, so Odoo is one of the accounting package. So Odoo is the acronym on demand open object. So ERP software Odoo is unique because it is open source. Okay, modular architecture. So it provides you with best in class sales and project management functionalities to start. It is available in both cloud based and on premises option. Okay, it is available to cloud based and on premises option. Now Bitrix 24. Okay, second one, next one is the Bitrix 24. So it is a free ERP software with integrated CRM, and it is available in cloud, that is free, or on premises, that is the paid. So with open source code access. Okay, so Bitrix 24 includes the apps of CRM, task management, employee management, document management, you can say the HR, that is the human resource management. So here it is a Bitrix 24. Now Microsoft Dynamics, okay? So business management solution Microsoft Dynamics offers a robust set of features, okay, that tackle financial management, human resource management, supply chain management, and workspace collaboration. So Microsoft Dynamics is a part of Microsoft Business Solution, coming from an industry leader. It is also known as for its top-notch business intelligence feature that lets user get actionable insights on their ERP data. So next one is the Tally ERP. Here is a famous accounting packages. So Tally ERP is the enterprise resource planning software developed by Tally Solution Private Limited. So it is one of the most popular accounting software, and it is used by in India. So it is a complete enterprise software for small and medium enterprise. So Tally ERP is the perfect solution for business management and goods and services tax, that is the GST software. It's an ideal combination, okay, functions, control, and inbuilt customizability. So it is a ERP solution provided, okay. Kaun se dekhe hume Oracle, SAP, Odoo, then Bitrix 24, then Microsoft Dynamics, and Tally ERP. So now ERP solution provided is now point is over. Now ERP and internet. So what is the internet? What is the ERP and internet? So one of the key benefit of implementing ERP system is to be standardized, streamline, okay, and organize the information, share the across the entire organization. The internet makes it easier to share and information across the entire organization. So there is a several need of organization to exchange the information, okay, with supplier and customer to meet the information requirement. So with the value from the ERP investment can be enhanced, okay, by taking the advantages of web-based ERP system of your organization. When you make your enterprise resource planning, that is the ERP solution, and a web-based enterprise system interface system, the internet becomes an enterprise information utility for the employees, partner, suppliers, and customers. Okay, so by making the ERP system a web-enabled interface, you can integrate the supply chain, speeding time to market, gaining manufacturing and efficiency. So it is alternatively a company can have a hybrid ERP that runs some of their system in the cloud and other system on premises. So that is the paid. Okay, so here it is, the small point is the ERP and internet. Now next one is the benefits of ERP. So it is a very small topics, okay. Then there are so many advantages of implementing the ERP system in an enterprise, okay. Some of the major benefits are the briefly explain in short mein explain kiya hua hai unhone. So first one is the improve the resource utilization, a better reporting tools with the real time information, and also a single source of truth on integrated database for all the business processes. Then next one is the better customer satisfaction. So better access to customer information and faster response time. Also the improve on time delivery, improve the order accuracy. Okay. Now provides the accurate information. So in today's competitive world, an enterprise to plan and manage the future cleverly. So to achieve this, enterprise need to high quality, relevant, updated and accurate information. So it is better data and decision making capability. Okay, so decision making capability means accurate and relevant information given to the decision maker helps to them to take the correct decision or better decision for the running system more smoothly. Now, next, increase flexibility. Okay, so an ERP system allows the organization to be more flexible. Okay, more flexible so that they can more easily capitalize on new business opportunity. Okay, so it is a benefits of ERP. Then, information integrity. Okay, so what is the information integrity and uska benefit kya hai? So centralized database, so that the complete the entire information about an enterprise is stored in centralized database. Okay, so that the complete visibility into all important process across the various department of the organization can be achieved. So here it is the benefit of ERP. First one is the